the live streaming first. I think since the teachers are, students are also waiting there. So kindly give me a green signal when the live streaming is there on to YouTube.
Madam, you can start. Live streaming is okay. And
okay.
I would like to request all the participants that kindly mute their mic for better communication. Thank you. Madam, okay. Can you start?
Thank you, Aminul. Welcome to all the teachers, students who are there with us on board at this platform, as well as on CSIR Jigyasa YouTube channel. So CSIO has been actively engaged in science outreach program catering to the students and teachers for creating curiosity in the students especially, and helping teachers to come up with a new ways or make students aware about what are the new findings, new research happening all over the country, because the students are the torchbearer of our country. They are the future generation. So we need to create a sense of curiosity in them. So with this aim, CSIR Jigyasa program was started. So I'll be sharing, since today it's an introductory lecture, so I aim to introduce you all about CSIR Jigyasa program, as well as the virtual CSIR virtual lab project, so that you all can get benefited of, your students can get benefited, and you can share amongst other students who can get benefited of this program. So let me share my screen. I mean, you just confirm like if everything is clearly seen in the screen. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and I hope I'm clearly audible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So before I go to the Jigyasa program, I believe many schools, teachers, and students might be aware of CSIR. If not, it's my humble duty to make you all aware about our organization, our institution, CSIR, which is Council for Scientific and Industrial Research. It has pan-India presence. So it is amongst the one of the oldest laboratory, which was established pre-independence era. The aim of this, it started with 4 laboratories, but now it has around 37 laboratories across the different parts of the country, which you can see over here. And generally, Prime Minister is the president of our society. And Science Minister, which is Dr. Jitendra Singh, is currently the Vice President of our society. And Dr. Shekhar Mande is Director General of CSIR. So if you see that there are different laboratories all over the countries, each laboratory has their vision, has their roles defined. They are working in different domains, including biological sciences, physical sciences, engineering sciences, and chemical sciences. So that is what we are a part of, the CSIR family. And as far as if I, there are many things which CSIR has impacted our society or country in several ways. If I give an example, while voting, there is an ink which is used to identify for the voters to confirm that voting has been done by that particular voter. That particular ink was developed by CSIR. So from that particular example to the current role which CSIR has played during COVID times. So you have seen this in last 1.5 year, which has been a very tough year for our country as well as globally. CSIR has played a very critical role. So its laboratory has developed several solutions in terms of developing devices like a portable ventilator or disinfected solutions, as well as a diagnostic kit like a Faluda, which is developed by our CSIR IGIP laboratory, and then oxygen enrichment unit, which is required for oxygen concentrator. CBRI laboratory, it has develop those ready to use hospitals. They have installed such units at several places in the country. And the vaccine, co-vaccine, which we, I think most of us are having this co-vaccine shot and different vaccines. So the adjuvant in the vaccine is developed by a CSIR lab. So you can see that how CSIR labs has played role from pre-independence era to the current era and continuously working towards various solution. Like one of, if I give an example of my laboratory, CSIO has developed portable ventilator, low-cost face shield solution, hands-free hand wash solution, as well as recently UVC-based disinfectant solution. So as to bring things at normal, and these solutions has been installed in various like in buses, public transport buses, railways, and also in parliament. CSIO has installed this UVC based disinfectant solution. So I'm sure now if somebody asks you in future about CSIR or CSIO, you would be able to make out what CSIR is and what CSIR labs are doing. Now, another important initiative that CSIR has taken, because you know that students are the torch period of R&D, science and technology in our country. So it is important that students should be given an exposure to field of science at very early age. So as a part of its social responsibility, scientific social responsibility, CSIR at a pan-India level has taken this program, which we know as Jigyasa. So this Jigyasa program, it aims to create a culture of curiousness and scientific nature. So this program was launched earlier with the name like students as Jigyasa, with the objective of connecting students with the scientist. So the complete objective of this program is to extend the classroom teaching. Like most of the students, they are confined into the classroom teaching. They go through textbooks and like marks-based learning. But this program aims to extend that learning beyond the classroom environment, give them exposure what is happening in different research labs in CSIR laboratories, as well as engage them, even students and teachers, to scientists who are working on different areas, and also teach them the learn art of observation, art of asking questions, and so that also that helps in future, that helps even to identify certain good students who could be bright students who can contribute in the field of science. So overall, if I define what are the objectives of this Jigyasa program, so this program aims to teach science or give exposure to the field of science by doing science alongside the skilled students, scientists who are practicing the science as their professional career. It also aims to improve the communication skills, especially what happens that scientists or the people who are practicing science, they work in silos and they are confined only in the laboratory environment. And then to the common public, it generally doesn't reach in a very what scientists are doing. So to have a better connect between the science, scientists and society, it is important to have a good communication skills, and that skills, it can be inculcated at a student level itself. So this is also one of the important objective of Jigyasa program. And other is that creating a positive perception towards science and scientists. When we ask students, like in a plus one and plus two or maybe 9th, 10th class, we ask them what they want to become. Generally, we get an answer like they want to become either engineer or a doctor or a teacher, or there are many other professions they talk about. Very rare we get to know that any student will say that they want to become a scientist. So this program aims to change that perception that becoming a scientist is not just that image that used to be in earlier, where the scientist is just working in the lab and is not having any social life. And so that is not this profession is. This profession is very satisfactory profession if you have a sense of curiosity and if you want to explore new things, innovative things. So that way this profession is completely different over other profession. So this program aims to change that perception, existing perception about this particular, about the science and scientist. And also creating a positive image about the scientist by showing or giving an exposure of the innovation and invention and their personal journey that they have go through to reach at this particular stage. And also this program also gives an awareness to the student at early age, various career option this particular field. And overall, this particular program creates a sense of scientific inquiry in the students. So these are the overall objectives of this Jigyasa program, which CSIR laboratories are taking throughout India at different levels. Now, to realize these objectives, how different CSIR laboratories, they are getting engaged with the students, engaged with the schools, teachers. There are different models of engagement which are available, and the teachers or students who are watching this program and they want to associate with CSIO, maybe in this particular Chandigarh region, we have different two CSIR laboratory here. So if they want to engage with us amongst any of these different models, they can contact us. So we have different programs like student residential program, where selected students, they are allowed to work in laboratory with scientists for a short-term project. Scientists go to school, they play a role of a teacher and try to explain the concept in a different way, which you go through reading your textbook. Teachers can get an exposure in laboratory. They can work as a mini for a short-term project as a scientist. There are many on-site experiments which are done by scientists and students who are practicing science into the schools. Students are allowed to visit the laboratory to see what are the kind of research happening in laboratories. Scientists, they are engaged with the schools through their science clubs, through their math club. And also we deliver the popular science lecture like I'm delivering today. And we also conduct different demonstration programs at schools. So the students get attracted. They see the concept which they are learning in their textbook and they see it in live and they learn it in a different see the different perspective of learning that particular concept. We also conduct science exhibition and we also help students who are participating in different competitive national level competition like Inspire Manak or National Children's Science Congress. And we are also conduct not only for the students, we also conduct the teachers training workshops to update teachers, because at the end it is the students can be engaged with for a short term, maybe short time, but these are teachers has the main role who take forward, who maintain the interest of the students. So we also conduct the training program for the teachers. And at last, not the least, we also support the tinkering laboratories. Like many schools has ATL labs, Atal Tinkering Labs. So we help the teachers, we help the students also to understand, to help them out to use this particular laboratory to build different projects and to facilitate them. So these are the different model of engagements by which schools can be connected with us. Now, if I give you an example, what CSIO has done. So this program has been running quite a last 2-3 years, and CSIO has been a very active contributor in this Jigyasa program. We have conducted several activities. To list a few, if I tell you, we have taken Scientific Saturday, where we visited schools, we conducted hands-on workshop, for 1 hour workshop on Saturday. This we have done before pandemic time, because during pandemic and now even physical visit is not that easy. There are certain constraints, but pre-pandemic time, we conducted summer camps, we conducted workshops, we conducted exhibition for science and maths, we delivered scientists of CSIO and other experts, they delivered the popular science lecture in school premise. We even gave the hands-on exposure on different experimentation in physics and chemistry. Also for the science communication, we conducted several competitions like writing science articles, as well as communicating any topic which is of interest to the student in a 2 minutes or 3 minutes short video. So we have conducted such kind of competition also, and students were invited to our institution. They were given an hands-on exposure on instrumentation, so they can build small projects, understanding how they can use different kind of electronic component, embedded system, how they can use and build small projects for a small solution which they see around it. So the overall aim was to give them an exposure. And besides that, we have our annual events, like we celebrate National Science Day, CSIR Foundation Day, CSIO Foundation Day, National Technology Day. So these are kind of open days where anyone, not only the students and teachers, anyone in like in general public, they can visit our institute, they can interact with the students doing PhD, masters here, they can interact with the scientists here. Since now we are doing this tour virtually, But we are hopeful when the things by next year, the things gets more better. The students and teachers are welcome to visit our institution. And we also conduct the awareness program regarding the different career opportunity, and also we conduct a various motivational lecture for the students. So these are some way of giving an idea what kind of activities CSIO has undertaken. And also we conducted the residential program. By residential program, we meant like students were selected amongst like around 10 to 11 students were selected based on certain set of criteria. And these students were assigned to the scientists in a group of 3 and 4. So they worked in our institute along with the scientists on mini projects, and they learned the skills of identifying the problem, learning what is research gap, what is hypothesis, and building the projects, and also making inferences and observation skills. So that is certain these are specialized residential program which we have conducted for the school students, and so these are some activities which we have done. Other activities which we did earlier was also we helped certain schools to build the science park. This we have done for the schools which we have adopted in Chandigarh region. And we also have some students, especially in the rural area, in establishing their science lab by giving them, by helping them, or in establishing the Atal Tinkering Lab. And also we tried, we hand-holded the teachers for ATL, especially for the ATL. So this we have done earlier. Now I wanted to tell you about what we did during the pandemic time. Like we know that in early 2020, when this COVID hit globally, so most of the students, they were locked in their homes. They were not allowed to visit to schools, go to lab. So this time we realized that in this taking advantage of digital era, virtual platform, we started this online webinar series, which is known as Let's Talk Science, What, Why and How. So you can see this all the series we hosted on to our CSIR Jigyasa YouTube channel. And you can see that in this series, what we did, this we invited the scientists and the students onto the same platform. And the students were allowed to interact with the scientists, where first the scientist delivered a lecture, maybe for 20 and 30 minutes, and the students was live, given a live opportunity to interact with the scientists, ask the question, ask the queries. And you can go through this, our YouTube channel, and you can see various lectures which we have conducted, covering from technical lectures to the career opportunity to different doubt clearing sessions. And so just you can, all these lectures, they are curated onto this YouTube channel. The advantage which we realize with this virtual platform is that the reach is more in comparison to when we talk about a physical visit, where we were limited to maybe one visit to one school or two schools at a time. This virtual platform, digital technology gave an advantage that we can reach to maybe 1,000 students at a one time. So I also another thing realized that since the students were locked at their home, they were not having an access of laboratories to perform experiments, to learn, to do hands-on thing. So with this, CSIR has come up with this virtual lab concept. So virtual lab concept, if you see, this is a website where from where you can access this virtual lab. So this virtual lab aims to create the content. What it is particularly doing, it is creating the content in a virtual form, with different forms. We have in the form of games, we have it in form of comics, simulation, infographics, videos, and interactive. So student can actually interact with this platform and have an experience which they would have when they were in the lab. So it is basically overcoming the problems, overcoming the challenges which happened during the pandemic time. The student at home can get a feel of actually working in the laboratory, get a feel of doing the experiment. Like in the school, there may be limited set of experimental instrumentation to perform the experiment. But while in a virtual lab, if I take an example of this simulation, so every student can perform the experiment and see if they are changing one variable, what will be the result. If they are changing another variable, what will be the result. So it increases the participation of the student more. So this is what the virtual lab concept is, and the aim of this virtual lab is to have reached to the last every last corner of the school, even into the rural area. So with this, CSIR started this virtual lab concept. As far as if I talk about CSIO has done in in the first phase of the virtual lab, CSIO has developed certain contents. I'll give a little bit glimpse of it, and I'll also share a link with you where you can access it. You can try, you can have your hands on, and also you can give us the feedback. So one of the problem which we felt that periodic table and understanding the elements, understanding the properties is also one of the very important thing which students learn in their 9, 10th or plus 1, plus 2 class. And we have seen that it's very difficult for the students to understand those elements, to understand their properties. So what we did, we have converted this periodic table or learning into a game. So the student can learn about the elements, student can learn their properties by this particular game. So this is, you can see, this is how the games look like, and it's a two-player, there are different levels into the game. And when student play this game, by end of the once the student finish the game, the student will I think 60-70% elements he would remember, and he plays it multiple time, and through basically fun learning, student will get to know all the properties of elements, even then their atomic number, their atomic mass, where is the position of that particular element. So this was just an example for you how we have converted the science learning into a fun learning. So by fun learning, one can learn this concept of scientific concept. So we have different levels into this game, and you can go through it. I will be sharing the link at the last. Even I'll be sharing it onto the YouTube platform, as well as this Google Meet platform. You can play it and you can give us the feedback. Another game which we have developed is for small kids, like from 6th to 8th class students, about understanding like primary, secondary, and tertiary colors, primary and secondary color. This game also is very fun game where the student get to know what is primary color and what is the wavelength and frequency associated with the color. So it gives the students that basic understanding about wavelength, color, frequency, solar spectrum. So again, it's a fun learning concept. Then another content which is developed by our laboratories, a simulation of an experiment, that is Young's double slit experiment. These are very common experiments which are done by, I think, 10th to plus 2 class student, how to find out the wavelength of a laser source. And many schools don't have the setup to perform this experiment, finding the wavelength of a laser and also finding the numerical aperture of an optical fiber. So students read about this concept like numerical aperture, they read about wavelength, but how to relating this concept, learning this concept by fun. So what we have done, we have developed the simulation. So if you can see, this is a one simulation where we have converted all the variables where the students has a freedom to vary like distance factor from the screen, distance between the slits, and try to find out what wavelength would be produced, what will be the color, what will be so they can understand this concept, they can understand this particular formula which is mentioned here, rather than just cramming it, and understand this formula, seeing the effect of different variable find the wavelength of the laser monochromatic source. So you can see where in the school environment or laboratory environment where the experimental kits are limited, everyone may not get a chance, everyone may not get that much time to do a lot of variation. In a simulation, that freedom has come. So in simulation, student can perform experiment many a times, student can observe the data, record the data variation, and understand what are the effect of different components. So another, likewise, we have done a very unique concept of graphical story or comics book. If you see, let me show you. Okay, let me try to play this for you. So if you see, so this video talks about atoms and colors. So we have converted this color concept of atoms and color by a small comics and small video, like a story. You know, students catch things by story more rather than giving them definitions. So this was just in a sample, and you can access the content again with the link I'll be sharing. So the point here is to convert the concept of science, which students feel difficult to understand, into stories, into comic books, into games, into simulations. So that is the whole concept of the virtual lab. So this was the first phase, and you can see we have converted all the stories also into comics books. The students like to read comic books, and they catch more, they catch through the characters, they catch through the dialogues. So we have converted it into different comics, in comic books also. We have done this for this particular type of content. We have developed for the water quality, understanding water quality, understanding atoms, understanding colors, and all this concept by these particular example. And also we have developed some small demo video, demonstration videos onto optical fiber, robotics, how to treat the water with light, onto renewable energy. So all this content will be accessible. And we also, under the virtual lab program, we give a virtual visit to the school students, to see what are the different activities, since the physical visit is not possible. So we have made a provision of giving a virtual exposure of the institution, which maybe in next session when we will be conducting, we will give you a visit to our institution as well as other institution, different institution nearby within the Chandigarh region, so that we will be planning soon. So these are the different links by which you can access these content, which I just gave an example. So you can access different these games, simulations, as well as comic books and animation video. I'll be sharing this link individually to the schools. And this is just to give you a glimpse of different programs which were conducted by us earlier, like before pandemic time. I will not take much time here to explain each and every program, because I already told what are the model of engagement by which schools and teachers can associate with us. So you can see we have mentored teachers, we have mentored students for the Children's Science Progress Project. You can see here the students visited our laboratory, or scientists have visited schools and conducted certain set of experiments for them, make them aware of different things. And so this is science exhibition we conducted, delivered lectures into the schools, and the school students, they have visited us. So this is the same thing. You can see different scientists of CSIO, they have visited schools. And since being an instrumentation organization, we have people from different background, including computer science, electronics, chemistry, physics, instrumentations. So even intellectual property, students were made aware about intellectual property, copyright, patents, how they can secure their innovation, how can they secure their ideas. So we are associated with the schools, government schools, Kendriya Vidyalaya School, Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalayas, and our scientists have even visited Jalandhar region, different schools into the Jalandhar region. So you can see all the glimpse over here. So here you can see that students have built this mini projects. Like you can see this mini robot Wally, they build in a 4 or 5 days. And here you can see they are understanding how to characterize LED, how to find out its wavelength. And you can see how the students are engaged with the scientists by developing small projects. So this is all about different projects taken up by the students and different workshops conducted by CSIO for the teachers, for the students. And you can see here the students visiting our laboratories. You can see here is the automation laboratory, mechatronics laboratory. Students were given exposure of it. So this is what all about different activities. So I'm not going more into detail. If there's any question I will be taking, I can take attend. And if there is anything the students want to, or teachers or schools, they want to engage among any of these programs with us, they can contact us. I'll just quickly go through it. So we have reached to the students even into the remote areas. And you can see there are demonstrations done by the faculties, students of the CSIO, PhD students, project staffs. So the kind of engagement, you can see how students are engaged with the scientists through experimentation. So this I will just quickly go through. And even we have done it for fifth class students in Havan School. And we have, you can see a glimpse of, again, National Children's Science Congress, and visit to different cluster schools in Pathankot region. So this is all about what activities we have undertaken, and we are undertaking. And in this phase itself also, Jigyasa Virtual Lab 2.0 will be taking several activities. So if student has and teachers or schools have special requirement, they can write to us, to Dr. Neerja, who is nodal for this program, and myself. And these are the links for the YouTube channel of CSIR Jigyasa program, where you can have an access to different lectures which are conducted by different CSIR laboratories. And this is in a link for access to virtual lab platform, which I told you about, where different activities are curated. This platform is yet to be officially launched, but I can share the link of the content which is developed by CSIO. So you can have a hands-on on that content, and even you can give us the feedback. Even I request the teachers, if they have certain concepts, certain ideas to share with us, which they want us to work upon towards developing the virtual content, that's also most welcome. So with this, I would like to thank all the students, teachers who are there on board with us. And if there are any questions, they can write to me, they can ask me directly. Thank you. Yes, Aminul.
Thank you, Pooja ma'am, for your valuable space and lecture for and wonderful demonstration. And I would like to thank all the scientists from various labs of CSIR for their cooperation, and all the teachers and all the students for their participation. And here I have attached one feedback form. You can give you feedback about this lecture and about our Jigyasa program. And before we end this session, I would like to announce something that I'm so excited to announce that we are going to organize various events on various topics that could be challenging and interactive under the Jigyasa program for overall growth of students. So at last, I want to thank all the scientists, teachers, students, and the entire Jigyasa team to make this event successful. Thank you all.
Thank you, Aminul.
Thank you.